Scoop and Scoop is sponsored by
Metropolitan International University. Get a Bachelor's in Information Technology and Computer Science, Arts and Science in Education, International Relations and Diplomatic Studies. To apply, please purchase application forms from the university or download from our website. Registration is now in progress at our main campus in Kisoro with branches in Bara, Kampala and Mitiana. Metropolitan International University, empowerment through knowledge creation. Another day. Okay, where do I need to start from today? Well, I think today's episode is proudly sponsored by all the very, very troubled people in Uganda. And when I say Uganda, I mean the entertainment industry. It's so beautiful when I see people going down in flames, and not flames that they threw at them, that they meant for themselves. It's just reliving. But hey, I don't decide their lives. I just decided to live a part of it in a way. When I'm doing these stories. But hey, besides that, never mind me. I'm under the weather. I have a cold, but it doesn't matter. Let's get to see what's happening in Celebrityville. My name is Tina. Like I said before, let's get it. Did I just see Diamond Platnumz on Instagram posting a video like he's so gangster and would? Have you ever seen it? Okay, first of all, this was very laughable. Ever tried to think of a Tanzanian trying to go blackish on you, like trying to be thug, trying to be, oh, you know, yo. Well, Diamond Platnumz just did that and I was in stitches. Well, according to the source that I do not even want to believe, he is throwing hate and shade at one particular artist. Now, someone else called me, they're like, no, he is not throwing that amount of shade to another fellow artist. He's throwing it at Ivan Ssemwanga. That's when I was like, Diamond Platnumz is throwing F-bombs. He is yelling out, you ain't rich. The only reason I don't pay attention to you is because you're broke. I have more money in the bank. I have more cars in the bank. I have this. I was like, yo, Diamond, when are you going to take the humble pill, man? Now, you see, it seems we have over-celebrated Diamond Platnumz. We have not said anything really, really bad about him. So it has kind of gotten to his head that he is a superstar. Diamond, we don't care if Forbes says you are $4 million rich. No, that is Forbes. And last time I checked, at times Forbes, there's an amount you can pay to be put on that list. Like, it doesn't matter. What is wrong with you? Why are you calling out people on how broke they are? We get it. You're making this money. You're out there. Netu Yambe, we don't really care much to know. If you want to diss someone, how about you real go thug on them and call them out? Stop being a sissy. This was you being a real sissy. Get on Instagram and say, so-and-so-and-so, I don't like you, so don't F with me. I don't like you. I have more cars. Tell it out. Be a real street thug and own up to whoever is throwing shade at you. This is so girly. You see, this is what happens. This is honestly what happens. You see, like when they say the Kardashian curse is real, there is the Zari curse. When Zari gets a man, before she gets a man, he is macho. When she gets a man, he becomes a sissy. He's a wuss. And this is Diamond Platnumz at his topmost wussiness and sissiness. Really? Own up. What's wrong? If you feel you're that G, you're that gangster, stand up and say, Gundi na Gundi, you're this and this and this. Why are you throwing around shade without owning up to it? But Zari, what do you do to these men? Do you sit them back in the back of your mind and you tell them we can do our nails and have tea and sip champagne? Girly stuff don't hurt? Because they're... Anyway, let's move from it. Apparently, Jackie Chandiru's guy is asking for divorce. Now, the story is running everywhere. People are telling whoever they care to tell. Sources from inside Jackie's family are yelling it. The guy is also somewhere on social media saying something. But I ask myself, why should we honestly care about this white man? I'm just asking. It's not like he has done anything. Now, from what they told me, he says that ever since he married Jackie Chandiru, all she has done is managed to spoil his name, put him out in that kind of bad light, and he honestly can't have it. He thought he was going to be a supportive husband when she went through rehab, but guess what? She relapsed again, so he's not having it. And I sat there, I was like, Nayono Muzungu wacha tumanira, what? What light are we seeing you in? The last time we checked, you are a crook, you are a fraudster. You're not even supposed to be called anything else. And you're here saying Jackie Chandiru is ruining your image. Negro, bye. Did I just call a white guy Negro?
But anyway, let's leave that for then. But seriously, why does this guy want to own up to something that he actually didn't do? Because I remember when Jackie was going through whatever it is she was going through, the only thing we ever heard is that he was paying rent. And at some point, they were about to throw her out of that apartment, which they did. And this guy is out here saying he wants a divorce. Here's the thing, I don't even think Jackie Chandiru deserves to give this guy a divorce, because I mean, it's up to her. She has nothing going for her right now. So being married to a white man is one of the best things she has done. But let's think about it. Even if she did grant this guy divorce, she can't take half of nothing. Because he has nothing. Absolutely. Omanyi, Jackie agenda na tumere chisenge cha 99 galoza afunye pension na. Nema na yabagesi jabali musiba. Anyway, that's the story. Apparently, he wants divorce. We don't really care much for him. He's aging. He doesn't have nothing to his name. There's no juicy story right there, is there? Did Cindy and Vampus just want to what now on stage? Hey! Ay, Lord God have mercy. I just watched a clip of Vampino and Cindy on stage, and they're doing... Do these guys even have a song together? They do. I think they do. So they're on stage together doing their thing, and Vampus is talking about how he wants to do things to Cindy, and Cindy's standing there with this look of like... You can gear it, boo. And then Cindy's going on different social media blogs and she's saying, I enjoy my single life. I am not pregnant. I'm having a blast. Vampus is out there saying he is married. And then someone sat next to them on a drunken night out in one of the hang spots. And apparently, boo. I'm going to use that one very, very much. Someone overheard Vampino saying he chowed, he slept with Cindy while she was still with Mario after she just had her child, like about 3 months into that. Now that's messy. Cindy. With every passing moment, I want to believe this woman has changed, but man, 3 months into it? While you were still with Mario? You let Vampus hit that? Oof. Makes me want to God, but let's move on.
Wow! I thought I had had enough of this conversation, but just for your viewing pleasure, now you remember how I told you there was that love triangle that I thought was so cute? Well, Cedric Babu's wife is out on Twitter ranting, screaming, yelling, asking for help, tagging Oxfam and World Health Organization and every poverty-stricken NGO. Guess what, hubby dearest and said mistress are up to? Well, they're just chilling, you know, they're just chilling at different hangout spots, having a bite of chicken at the KFC. And I'm like, Alison, you haven't yet smelt the coffee. You're still fighting for this guy.
3 days after your story broke, he was seen at a hangout joint with this chick. The same chick who's breaking up your home.
Damn, it just says one thing. Karo pulls the strings. I mean, they're holding this guy by the nuts.
Literally, but hey, don't think I'm kidding. Just watch this.
Exclusive. Meanwhile, the video is very shaky. It was recorded by a child. But you will be able to notice the guy in the blue cape and the chick in the black t-shirt at the KFC.
ScoopOnScoop was sponsored by
Metropolitan International University. Get a Bachelor's in Information Technology and Computer Science, Arts and Science in Education, International Relations and Diplomatic Studies. To apply, please purchase application forms from the university or download from our website. Registration is now in progress at our main campus in Kisoro with branches in Bara, Kampala and Mitiana. Metropolitan International University, empowerment through knowledge creation.